Welcome everyone to Steiner Auctions Online. I'm here to give a tutorial on how to operate our website if you're not familiar. And if you are familiar, a few things that you may or may not know that will definitely help you navigate our site moving forward. The first thing to know is our website is auction.steinersports.com, but you can also find it at steinerauctions.com. It'll populate back to the same page, and the reason we did that, it's a little bit easier to find, steinerauctions.com as opposed to auction.steinersports.com. I want to explain how to navigate more than one auction at a time. The main tile here is usually what announces what we have going on. So right now we have the Winter Classic auction that's open. It ends February 10th at 10:30. This is a clickable banner, and this will take you right into the auction that you're clicking on. So if we have more than one auction, this will only take you into the auction that you're actually clicking on. This page here is what we call our main auction page as far as being able to bid. This page right here is what we call our auction landing page, where our auction actually rests, where you can actually participate and bid. You can select how many lots per page you'd like to view. So you can pick 25. I usually like to go with 100 lots per page. I like to navigate an auction from beginning to end, so 100 lots helps me get there a little bit faster. We just went from 34 pages to 9, so I can do 9 pages pretty quickly if I know what I'm looking for. If you guys know what you're looking for, you can navigate. Obviously, the page becomes a lot longer with a lot more lots there, but it'll definitely help ease the navigation. If you prefer to search by category, on the left-hand side of the page is our categories. The one thing to keep in mind is all of the lots here, it says 1,004. However, there's only a little bit over 800 lots in this auction, so don't take this number to heart. What this means is there might be a few items that are in more than one category, and it'll look like there's a few more lots than there actually are. So if you come on and see 3,580 categories here in the all selection, that does not mean there's 3,000 categories. We might have 1,000 items in 3 to 4 categories each, and it might actually be very easy to navigate, which is why going to the top here and selecting 100 lots per page and actually having the amount of page to navigate right here is a little bit easier sometimes. You can also sort by different things as well, which is very helpful. You can search by price, most recent bids, lowest lot number. I like to search by most recent bids. Tells me kind of what's going on in the auction, if there's action happening. And as I can see here, there's bids that were just placed since I last viewed this auction. So it's always fun and always unique to search by most recent bids. But that's not the most efficient way if you're really searching the entire auction. You probably just want to start at the lowest lot number or the highest dollar amount, whatever fits your needs there. One of the most important things, if not the most important thing, when navigating more than one auction on our page is to understand the search bars as well as the area under My Account where you're able to watch your consignments. Very often, people are confused and they go to search the auction right here and they'll search something that they've seen in our catalog that they know is in the auction and it's not coming up. That doesn't mean it's not available. That means it may be in the other auction. So when we have more than one auction on the left-hand side of your page, you'll see Select Auction, and there'll be a drop-down menu here that's usually populated. So if you just wanted to select our weekly auction and search all the lots in that auction, you would simply select the weekly auction and can click the amount of lots you want to search by. Again, I usually go with 100. And there's 4 pages to search. So you can pretty quickly and pretty easily search the entire weekly auction, 343 categories in total, so not a ton of items. And as you can see here, we'll pick an item to search WC Fields. So if we're using this search bar, you can search by a few different things. Lot number, title, and description. Description, serial number. Searching by title is usually the easiest way. Sometimes title and description is good, but sometimes you'll get a name like Ken Griffey Jr. and he won't even be in the item. We're just comparing a player to him, so that'll broaden the horizon a little. Might not be what you're looking for. So if we search WC Fields, you can see that we have one item in the weekly auction. However, if the Winter Classic auction is highlighted and you're searching WC Fields, nothing will pop up. So if you come in the auction page and you just received a catalog in the mail and you type in the player's name you're looking for or person of interest and nothing pops up, that doesn't mean that we don't have anything for them for sale. That just means you're not searching across all of our auctions. So it's very important to use the search across all auctions function when searching for what you're looking for, and what you're looking for will pop up right there. The search bar on the top will actually search across both auctions as well. So if you use that search bar up top, that's going to give you all of the items in both auctions. So what it'll do is it'll show all of the items in the weekly auction, these four, and then it'll show the rest of the items. There's 15 Babe Ruth items in the big auction, and all those items will pop up as well. So always keep in mind when you're searching, the top search bar here will search both auctions. The search bar is large, it's right in your face for a reason, and that will allow you to search all of our auctions. If you're using this search bar, make sure you're clicking the appropriate auction, searching across all auctions, and using this properly, or else you will not find what you're looking for. Since everyone in today's age uses a mobile device, it's very important that we also show you how to navigate on your mobile device here. So the mobile device works pretty much just like the standard desktop device. The layout's exactly the same, just some slight modifications to make things a little bit easier for you. So you want to click into the auction banner of the auction you're going to be participating in. I clicked on the Winter Classic, and we'll go and take a look at that here in a second. Now that we're in the auction, navigation is a little bit easier, and also on the mobile, it automatically populates to 22 lots per page as opposed to the 100 or so lots that we were able to do on the desktop. If you're more comfortable with the desktop from the phone, there's actually a way that you can do it. If you scroll all the way to the bottom, you'll have your main tab here, so you can select the different options. You can go to the account login, consign with us, search the auction, view all the auctions. But if you keep scrolling all the way to the bottom, you'll see on the very bottom where it says mobile and desktop, that'll actually switch you back. So if you click desktop like I just did here, this will take you to the desktop version. So you can just shrink that down to however you want to view it. And you can view the auction just like you were working on the desktop if that's what you're more comfortable with. However, if you're more comfortable with the mobile version, you'll go back down to the bottom again and you'll switch back over. A lot of people think this is where it ends, but that's actually not. It goes even under the logo here. You'll see mobile and desktop, and you'll want to select the mobile option on the very bottom. Now that we're back in the mobile and you want to search the auction, you'll notice we don't have that large search bar like we did on the desktop version. So there's only one search bar. So if you go to the search bar and you're trying to search an item, we'll go and we will search WC Fields, because we know that there's only one WC Fields item in one auction. And we click search, and you'll get this blank area here in the center, and that looks like there's nothing available. However, you'll have to select the auction here. You click select auction, and you'll notice there's more than one auction running live, so it's very important to always click that select auction to try to find what you're looking for. And you'll see the item that we were searching right here can only come up if the auction that you're searching for is highlighted. So it's very important when you're searching on the mobile device to make sure the auction's selected. The weekly auctions are a little bit smaller, so if we have a big catalog auction going on, it's always very important to select that big catalog here, in this case the Winter Classic, and make sure that populates in the select auction area before we start our search.
When navigating My Account, there's a few things to consider. The My Account feature is located on the upper right-hand corner of the page. It just disappeared. Okay. The My Account, the way you can find your account if you're looking to log in or find your activity is by making sure first you're on auction.steinersports.com. Oftentimes, people will go to Steiner Sports because that's where they do a lot of their purchases from. They'll be on the main Steiner Sports website and they'll go to login because that's what they're accustomed to doing, and they'll try to put their login information here. And what they'll then want to do is they'll go and click the auction button and try to participate in the bidding of the items. And what'll happen is they're not actually registered or logged in yet in order to bid, because they're logged in on Steiner Sports main page. So what you need to make sure is make sure you're on SteinerAuctions.com or auction.steinersports.com. Go to the upper right hand where my account page and click that, and this is where you can log in. So I'm already logged in. So what I'll do is I'll log in for demonstration purposes here. And now I've gotten into my account. So I've gone to the My Account page, I've clicked that, and it gets me right into where I need to be to search the auctions. Now, something very important here, you'll see there's nothing I'm watching, nothing I'm winning, nothing I'm losing, nothing I've consigned, no past invoices. Obviously, this account is just a test account here, but you'll see there's multiple auctions that you can select here. So it's very important to select the auction that you're trying to watch from the Select Auction tab. So if you are watching 50 items and you have 12 consignments and you're bidding on another 25 items and the wrong auction is selected right here, you'll actually, nothing will come up. So it's very important to make sure you select the correct auction and that all of your information will then populate. So very often, a common issue that it comes across is that people are not selecting the correct auction. And when we run two auctions at a time, like we do a few times a year during our big catalog auctions, this is when we'll have an issue. So it's very important to select the correct auction you're in and making sure you're navigating that way. Of course, if you haven't registered, you can click the Register to Bid tab right here. You can put all your information in. A credit card is required when you register. All it does is put a dollar authorization on, which then falls off, so it's make sure you have a valid credit card, and we don't take American Express. Also make sure you click I've accepted the rules and I've read them, and make sure you do read them as well. It's very important. You can also find the auction rules at this very next tab right here. And again, it's very important to read these rules, because these rules will be the guidelines for how you participate in our auction. Oftentimes, a situation will arise and a client will call up, and it's very simply stated right in the rules how something works in our auction as far as our bids, a ceiling bid, the 15-minute rule, shipping costs, frames, being outbid, reserves, all sorts of different things. So it's very important. It's not long. It's a very quick read. It's about a few hundred characters, so please make sure you read the rules prior to bidding, and that's why you select that button. If you're interested in consigning an item, we have the tab right there. You can just simply drop in some contact information and what you have, and someone will get back to you pretty shortly. Our direct phone number is right here as well on top of the page. So that number is usually good to get us during business hours. And sometimes on the auction close night, we'll be in pretty late. If you don't get anyone at this line, please use the Consign With Us tab or the Contact Us button right here. If you have a general question or an issue or anything at all, you can always use the Contact Us button. Again, going to steinersports.com and going to the Contact Us page there is not as direct as going on the steinerauctions.com page and pushing the Contact Us. This will take you right to auction@steinersports.com. And if you need to reach us, you can certainly copy this auction@steinersports.com into your browser and email us directly as well there, and we'll try to get back to you within about 24 hours. Of course, the phone number is probably a little bit more direct, but again, that's pretty much our Steiner auctions in a nutshell. So I'll quickly run through it real quick with you. We can click auctions on this tab here. It'll take you to our main page where the bidding takes place. You can click this button, go into the auction of your choice, and start navigating however you please. But if you just want to search all of our auctions for something specific, you can use this search bar up top, and it'll show you all the items we have for that specific person available at any time in all of our auctions on the page. So if you ever search in that top search bar and nothing pops up, most likely we probably have it, it's just not online yet. So feel free to call us if you have an item of interest as well, and we might be able to get that for you. But if you're looking just to search our auctions, make sure you select the auction you want to search and have at it.